So these three factors that are known, the fasting, high fasting insulin, mm-hmm. the high free estrogen,
right.
and the high inflammatory markers. So right. as measured by certain biomarkers like C-reactive protein.
Right.
So these are all associated with, in some cases, even 2 to 3-fold increased risk.
Yeah, it's definitely 2-fold and maybe definitely. A little bit more. I think that's generally the metric we use. Each one of them increases the risk individually by 2-fold. Combination-wise, we don't know. It's probably not quite additive, but they still would have a combined effect, too. That's, you know, reason to look at all these different pathways. But those are definitely the three major metabolic pathways that we think feed into having kind of fertile soil so that when these DNA changes happen, they're in a place where they're kind of like fertile soil, more likely to go to an invasive tumor type.
Okay. And what's so interesting about this is that your work and the work of others is showing that these three different biomarkers, let's say, they can be modified by changing your lifestyle pattern.
Right. Much of my research lately has focused on timing of meals, which I think is a little bit of a newer hypothesis. We all evolved to eat during the day when we're out getting our food and then fast at night when we're in a rest state. But now with, modern lighting and with modern lifestyles and longer and longer work weeks, our meal patterns less and less resemble the way we evolved to eat. And we believe that it's very metabolically detrimental to eat a lot of energy and then right away lay down. What are you doing? You're laying down. You don't need to have all that energy on board and all that metabolism going on when actually you should be in a fasting catabolic state.
And most people probably actually eat one of their largest meals in the evening.
Right, which is just so counter, just even in a common sense way, why do you need all that energy right before you're about to become completely comatose? it makes no sense, right? You really need the energy during the day, when you're busy up walking.
That's a very good point. And I think you also mentioned another important point, and that is eating during the day when we're supposed to eat and timing it with our circadian rhythm,
right,
which is the biological clock inside of our every cell. We've got a master regulator and different tissues, which we can talk about in a minute. But that master clock, what's interesting is that it regulates, between 10-15% of the human genome is regulated by these clocks. And mm-hmm. about 50% of those genes are involved in metabolism.
Right.
And humans are the most insulin sensitive mm-hmm. upon waking, first thing in the morning. And then as the day goes, insulin sensitivity goes down. And mm-hmm. so, eating your biggest meal in the evening when you're the most insulin insensitive would increase one of those biomarkers that
Absolutely.
You're talking about.
Right, or just metabolically dysregulate you, which is what we're trying to have, regulated metabolism. And that definitely dysregulates it. And the whole circadian rhythm concept is the idea that, as you mentioned, the master clock is trained to light. It responds to light. So the master clock's getting the signal, let's say in the evening, you're done. But if you're eating, the peripheral clocks, like in your liver, are going, no, we're waking up, we're getting energy. And we believe that when those two clocks are out of sync, that itself leads to some type of metabolic dysregulation. And we don't have fully metabolic, molecular understanding of exactly how this works. But it's a pretty solid theory, at least what we've seen in animal research.
Yeah.